Why are we still taping? Because outstanding progress is being made. For example, I woke up this morning and I was aware of the totality of self-delusion. I was aware of it. So the question is, and the taping here is about, how do you respond? What do you do when you see it? So far, so good. I've remained poised, practicing full stop in the wow, not struggling with it. Quite amazing. Quite amazing. You don't know exactly what to do, actually. It is so tricky. What we're engaged with is so tricky that it's best just to stay, sort of observe it. Don't try to resolve it. Don't try to do anything about it. Just notice it, and then keep yourself in neutral, a full stop in the wow mode. So it's working. This practice that we're doing is working. So this morning I've been engaged with the acceptance that I can become aware of this, and practicing the full stop in the wow here. Now, can we even talk about it? Yes, there are ways to address our situation, and it's right along the lines of what we've been doing, actually. The key is, well, it's tough to key in on any one facet, except to say, what I found helpful was to say, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. This is perhaps the most powerful help that we can give ourselves, is to continue with the statement, because this statement encapsulates the right perspective in looking at this delusionary dream of what you might call is attainment, a dream of attainment, is you need to remind yourself, I'm not a body, I'm free, I'm still spirit exactly as God created me. And that enables one to recognize this delusion that we're engaged in. Very crazy delusion of what we might say is attainment. We're looking for the feeling of attainment instead of the feeling of isness. Instead of the feeling of freedom, we're looking for the feeling of attainment. And so we have this delusion, which is, when you see it, you can see it, but to explain it or describe it is difficult. And you shouldn't struggle with trying to describe it. This is what I'm saying. Don't struggle. When you see it, don't struggle and try to describe it. Okay. If you see it and you say, yeah, I saw this, those who have seen it also, they will understand what you're talking about. You don't have to describe it to them, right? What we have is this illusion of attainment. We're looking for the feeling of attainment, of success, of progress, attainment, of arriving, of accomplishing. Feeling of accomplishment. And there's no such feeling in reality at all. No such feeling as that. We're already free. We can never get rid of this feeling. The feeling we have is one of perfect freedom. That is our feeling. And we're trying to turn that into a feeling of accomplishment, which is impossible. And we have this delusional situation we've dreamed up, we call bodies in the world, that seems to be have the potential for attainment and accomplishment, and yet it doesn't. It doesn't. Not at all. When you see things the right way, which I did this morning, you recognize there's nothing happening at all. There's no accomplishment happening at all. There's no attainment taking place at all. There's no success. There's no recognition. There's no realization. There's nothing taking place, actually. But if you look at it at the level of the illusion, then you feel trapped and you feel that it is. It's quite something how we are tricking ourselves. So don't struggle. Don't struggle with the explanation. I've been able to not struggle with it this morning, which is very good. So no attainment. There's no attainment. There's no realization. There's no recognition. There's no enlightenment. There's nothing that has anything to do with attainment. I've always been free. It's always been nothing but the play of freedom. Everything is just a play of freedom, actually. There's no attainment. There's no location. Another thing that's helpful is to say, I am nowhere. I am absolutely nowhere. And this is what I did last night, and I believe this helped bring about this recognition, but not a recognition of attainment, a recognition of no attainment. Not a realization of attainment, a realization of no attainment. Not an enlightenment as an attainment, but an enlightenment of no attainment. No success. No success is needed. No attainment is needed. Success and attainment are all based on our arrogance of trying to contest with God, to be in a contest with God, to try and win reality away from God. Through a contest, actually. But there isn't any contest taking place. There's also no vibration really taking place. That's an illusion too. Vibration is an illusion. Pure spaciousness is not vibrating. There are no vibrations happening with pure spaciousness. Pure spaciousness is still, is calm, is still. It's not vibrating, it's not moving. You cannot take any part of this illusion as real and escape the rest of it. You will become trapped then. So the key is to realize none of it is real. There's not one speck of it that is real. There's no attainment situation present at all. Not even one. Not even one. As soon as you take one to be true, then they all seem true. And then you seem horribly trapped in a feeling of a need that you need to attain. Now, when you come into this world, as we experience it, everybody welcomes you and says, all right, you know, you're very fortunate to be here in this world. You get to work on a lot of accomplishments. And of course, our spirit says, no, I don't need to accomplish anything. I can't. It's just like, pure freedom can never locate itself. It's non-locatable. Pure freedom has no location. It has no attainment. It has no accomplishment whatsoever. Now, our spirit, we as spirit know this, and yet our habit of trying to be greater than God, our arrogance, blinds us to this. Now, we're in a time when we're focusing on accomplishments and to an unprecedented extent, and we feel that we're going to actually accomplish something ultimate soon. And I feel like I was talked into coming back here against my spiritual wisdom that said, no, there's nothing to accomplish. It's all an illusion. Because we're in this time of great accomplishment, supposedly, and there was this feeling that everybody who was very accomplished, needed to, in the previous lives, needed to come back to this world now and add their feeling of accomplishment and try to encourage everybody to attain it, this a great accomplishment. So I had quote unquote a lot of great accomplishments previously. So I had sort of the habit of accomplishment. So I came back here, was talked into coming back here to help out with some great accomplishment. But this is all delusion. Absolutely, it's totally delusion. Illusion, delusion, arrogance. Accomplishment's impossible. There's no such thing as accomplishment. Nothing is being accomplished whatsoever. Absolutely nothing. There's merely play of appearances. But there's no accomplishment taking place. We're not making any progress. We're not succeeding in anything. This is the kind of talk you need to hear based on what I saw this morning, no question about it. Now, if you come here to this world and say, "Well, I have an appearance," in order to help you free yourself from the delusion of success and accomplishment, and people will say, "Well, you know, no, you're wasting your life. You're supposed to. Your life is based on accomplishment. What have you accomplished?" Our lives are not based on accomplishment. Our lives are based on freedom. Freedom doesn't need to accomplish anything. God doesn't need to accomplish anything. And as far as being here, I'm not anywhere at all. I don't have any location. I'm location freeness. There isn't any here. There is no location. Freedom is not locatable. But what we have is we have an appearance, which is reassuring that we don't need accomplishment. Don't need accomplishment. So you can say, I know that I'm not here. Absolutely not here. I'm not anywhere. I know that I'm not here. I'm not anywhere. Now, the reason why we're afraid to do this this is knocking out the notion of accomplishment and success and attainment and finishing and all this stuff. And we think that our identity is based on this, as if we were created to with some need to complete ourselves. This is not true at all. All of this is actually our own deception, trying to deceive God into believing that reality is attainable, something that has to be attained, and that we're trying to attain it, and thereby, you know, steal it from God, as it were. So we're believing in this notion of attainment and success and accomplishment. What we're really trying to accomplish and attain and succeed at is to usurp reality from God, be greater than God. And that's impossible. There's no attainment in reality. Nothing to attain. We already are everything. All is all. All is already all. So what we're doing here is knowing that this recognition can arise sometimes in dreams or in sleep, or when you wake up from sleep, you realize that you're seeing something that you can't quite explain. And you don't need to explain it exactly, because, again, truth already is aware, knows about this, and the remedy is known. So you need to just take it in stride and say, okay, I see this, that's great. So what's the remedy? And the remedy is not one of accomplishing anything. It's non-accomplishment. Not buying into the notion of accomplishment in the first place. And we don't need to undo any accomplishments because no accomplishments have actually taken place. Only freedom has been playing. That's it. And freedom is still free. Hasn't changed at all. Now it might seem that going over all this, you know, what does that accomplish? We say, well, what's accomplished is the accomplishment of no accomplishment. Where we remember, oh, yeah, I remember myself, my spirit, my free spirit. This has just been a dream, a nightmare. That's what is. The attainment of no attainment, of non-attainment, is what's attained. The attainment is of non-attainment. The accomplishment is of no accomplishment. No accomplishment required, no accomplishment necessary. No attainment required, no attainment necessary. So this experience, I had this experience, and I said, okay, don't struggle with it, full stop in the wow. Just practice full stop in the wow. When you have this recognition, try not to struggle with it. Now, I looked at it a little bit and came up, you know, flipping the script. I worked on flipping the script and also full stop in the wow. So this is what this practice enables us to do, is we can see this cleverness that we've been employing to make it to make it seem like something's happening when it's really not. I am no place. I am no place at all. I'm nowhere. I'm absolutely nowhere. I am absolutely nowhere. So yes, I already know that I am absolutely nowhere. Yes, I'm already experiencing that I am absolutely nowhere. And I'm already experiencing that I'm absolutely nothing, no thing. I'm absolutely no thing. I'm absolutely nothing. I'm absolutely nowhere. So, of course, everyone here is struggling for some attainment. And why spiritual practice is so important is glimpsing truth and then full stop in the wow of it. Don't struggle. Don't try to turn it into an attainment. Realization is not an attainment. It's accepting that attainment is impossible. I'm absolutely nowhere. I'm absolutely nothing. No thing. Nothing. I'm absolutely nothing. I can never be defined. I'm absolutely undefinable because I'm absolutely nowhere and I'm absolutely nothing. So I'm undefinable. Freedom is completely undefinable. So yes, I already know that I'm absolutely nowhere and I'm absolutely nothing. Now we don't have to understand what this means exactly. We just have to keep asserting it and getting comfortable with it and managing our success, managing the shock of this. And this is what it's all about. It's not an attainment. It's a discipline that leads to realization of non-attainment. I'm absolutely nothing. I'm absolutely nowhere. I'm absolutely attainment free. I'm absolutely progress free. I'm absolutely success free. I'm absolutely winning free. So it's very helpful to speak of it in this way. Not this, not this, not this. I'm very, very helpful. Because it emphasizes all these positives that we think are, that's the answer. That's actually the trouble. So insist, no, I'm absolutely nowhere. I am absolutely nowhere. I am absolutely nothing. I am absolutely success free. I'm absolutely attainment free. I'm absolutely progress free. I'm already progress free. I'm already attainment free. I'm already absolutely nothing. I'm already absolutely nowhere. I'm already absolutely progress free. I'm already absolutely success free. I'm already absolutely attainment free. So this is the type of practice that I saw that arose for me as I viewed this clever dream of illusion and had an overview of it. This is what arose for me to practice this in this way. Don't try to resolve it, attack it, describe it, explain it. Assert the truth that I am absolutely nothing. I am absolutely nowhere. And the more we do this, the more perspective we will get, better perspective we will get on this, until we'll be able to see it so clearly that it would just say, ah, and then we can just dismiss the dream. It no longer fools us in any way. So I am absolutely nowhere. I'm absolutely nothing. I'm absolutely success-free, attainment-free, progress-free, accomplishment-free. I have absolutely no accomplishments whatsoever. I have absolutely no attainments whatsoever. I have absolutely no success whatsoever. I have absolutely no progress whatsoever. I have absolutely no path whatsoever. I have absolutely no winning whatsoever. Absolutely winning-free. Absolutely progress-free. Absolutely success-free. Absolutely attainment-free. I am absolutely nowhere. I am absolutely nothing. I am absolutely never. I am absolutely never. I am absolutely never and nowhere and nothing. I am absolutely attainment free. I have no attainment whatsoever. For me, attainment is impossible. For me, success is impossible. For me, accomplishment is impossible. For me, progress is impossible. I am progress free. Now, we're not used to saying these things, right? I mean, who goes around saying these things? Only we do. That's about it. This is non-dual. Only the non-dualists, those who are truly oriented towards truth, go around asserting like this. The world doesn't do that. It's the opposite. The world is constantly asserting the opposite. So people probably have a wow reaction come up from this, just because, like, wow, I can't believe that I'm even saying these things, saying this, or thinking this, believing it, wow. But this is the medicine. Yes, I already know that I'm absolutely nothing. I'm very happy to be absolutely nothing. I'm very happy to be absolutely nowhere. I'm very happy to be absolutely never. I absolutely never am. I never am. I never am. I never am. It's just I am. I am never am. I never am. I am. See, difference. Never means time. I'm never. I never am. I already know that I never am. I already know that I'm never anywhere. I already know that I'm never anything. I already know I'm absolutely never anything. I already know I'm absolutely never anywhere. I already know that I'm absolutely never, never. Absolutely never. I already know I'm absolutely never. And I know I'm already absolutely never anywhere. Absolutely never anything. Now this is producing a wow reaction, as it should. As it should. We've never spoken in this way. I've never addressed my beingness in such a way. And you might say, I'm never addressable either. I'm never addressable. I'm absolutely unaddressable, absolutely unlocatable, absolutely nothing. Absolutely never, absolutely unaddressable, absolutely untouchable. Yes, I already know that I'm absolutely untouchable, that I'm absolutely nowhere, absolutely nothing, absolutely never. And it's our capacity to full stop in the wow that enables us to do this. And of course, in this world where we have these, all the terminology is dualistic. Whatever term we use, people will say, well, you're being dualistic. Well, then you just say nothing at all, like Ramana Maharshi, actually. we could do that. But we're the mood of repentance is not troubled by levels of terminology. So if we say we're making progress, we mean, of course, we're making progress to the realization, recognition, acceptance that there is no progress. We're on the path of no path, the progress of no progress. We're making progress to no progress. That's understood. It's inferred here with non-dual talk. It's inferred. The non-duality of the goal is inferred. That's the root of language and talking that we're, it's the root of it. It's already inferred, you see. That's why the mood of repentance, a repentant mind, is not troubled. It can get this. It can get that there's nothing to get. Yeah, I get that there's nothing to get. I'm absolutely non-gettable. Totally non-gettable. There's nothing to get. There's nowhere to go. There's nothing to attain. There's nothing to realize. There's nothing to get. Nothing to win. There's nothing to win. Absolutely nothing to win. So again, I feel this is causing a reaction. No question about it. Almost like an icy reaction. It's hitting like the nerves, or it's hitting something, you know, it like really strongly in some way. So it's like we're taking our medicine. I know there's absolutely no success. There's nothing to succeed. I'm nowhere. I'm not anywhere. I'm absolutely nowhere. I'm absolutely nothing. I'm absolutely non-accomplished. I am absolutely non-accomplished. Yeah, now we're really getting somewhere in our practice, and just in time. I can feel like a coldness up my spine, as it were. Yeah. I am absolutely non-accomplished. I'm absolutely perfectly non-accomplished. I am absolutely perfectly non-accomplished. Yes, I already know that I am absolutely perfectly non-accomplished. I am absolutely perfectly unsuccessful. I am perfectly unsuccessful. I am absolutely perfectly unsuccessful. Again, this is causing like a feeling of coolness throughout my nervous system. It's in the lower spine area now, and various areas of the body. It's like a cold pack has been applied, sort of. There's some reactions taking place to this. Maybe cooling down the fever of attempted accomplishment. This world is in a fever. It's a feverish place. That's why we call it hell. It's a hot, feverish place of people frantically pursuing accomplishment. Yes, I already know that I'm absolutely perfectly non-accomplished, that I'm absolutely perfectly unsuccessful. See, what we're doing is we're waking up to I am. Waking up to just I am. Not I am this or I am that. The I am-ness, the freedom of I am-ness. In order to do this, we need to drop the false contest identity, the false path of success, accomplishment, progress towards winning. I'm already absolutely perfectly unaccomplished. I'm already absolutely perfectly unaccomplished. So again, this practice is what has arisen out of experiencing and seeing and being aware of the fundamental dynamic of self-delusion. And instead of trying to describe it or explain it, I'm going into assertions. This is the wise path. The pathless. This is what takes us to the no path. The path of no pathness. Yes, I already know that I'm absolutely perfectly free of any path. I'm pathless. I'm absolutely perfectly pathless. Yes, I already know that I am absolutely perfectly pathless. Yes, I already know that I'm absolutely perfectly pathless. absolutely free of all opportunity. Yes, I'm absolutely free of all opportunity. See, freedom is not opportunity, it's freedom. Freedom is freedom. Freedom is freedom. Freedom is freedom. This is the acceptance. This is what is. Freedom is freedom. It's not something else. It's not opportunity. It's freedom. So I already know that I am absolutely perfectly free of all opportunity. I'm absolutely perfectly free of all success. I'm absolutely perfectly unsuccessful. I'm absolutely perfectly free of all opportunity. I'm absolutely perfectly free of all accomplishment. Now, just to hear this is super rare in this world. I can tell you this. What we're doing right now is super, super rare. You simply do not come across this sort of practice very often here. Yes, I already know that I'm already absolutely perfectly accomplishment free. I have absolutely free of any accomplishment. I have no accomplishments whatsoever. I've never had any accomplishments whatsoever. Yes, I already know that accomplishment is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that attainment is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that success is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that opportunity doesn't exist for me. Success doesn't exist for me. Yes, I already know that opportunity doesn't exist for me. Yes, I already know that winning doesn't exist for me. And these practices are like manna from heaven, really. This is just something quite extraordinary. And we can even say, yes, I already know that extraordinary doesn't exist for me. Yes, I already know that success absolutely doesn't exist for me. I am absolutely nowhere. I am absolutely nothing. I am absolutely never. I am absolutely never. Yes, I already know that winning is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that success is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that accomplishment is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that progress is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that attainment is impossible for me. Now, far from being some sort of downer, this is like the ultimate upper. You know, yes, but and we say yes. I already know that all upperness is impossible for me. Hummingbird right beside me here, right beside me there. Hummingbird came right up here, just off. I don't know. Maybe he got on camera there for a moment. I don't know. If you if Maybe it did. Maybe it did. Wow, that's quite interesting. It might have been on camera here. It's possible. It's like right here. Is this on camera? I think it is. You might have seen that. I didn't see it because I was looking, just taping. Wow. That's quite extraordinary. If it got on camera. Come on camera, hummingbird. Absolutely. And we continue with anything positive. We say it's impossible for me. Yes, I already know that positivity is impossible for me. You see, all I am is freedom. Freedom is freedom. That's it. Freedom is freedom. Anything else is this delusion of a contest. Anything else is this arrogance of a contest. Anything else is the arrogance of a contest. Yes, I already know that contests are impossible for me, can never exist for me. Yes, I already know that contests can never exist for me. Can never exist at all. Yes, I already know that winning can never exist for me. So, I already know that I can never win. There is no winning for me. So the wow reaction, again, focus on that and acknowledge it and recognize it. Instead of struggling when you kind of hit this flat spot, is because that your practice has been so successful that you're momentarily stunned by it. This is what's happening right now. If you look back over this video and what we've been saying, this is absolutely stunning what we've been saying. So of course it's going to produce a stunned reaction. This is just counter to everything the world has taught us. It counters everything the world has taught us. I might say, yes, I already know. I have absolutely no purpose. I have absolutely no purpose. See, freedom is freedom. That's it. It doesn't have a purpose. It is freedom. We've forgotten what freedom is. So we try to substitute, say, there's a purpose. But purpose is always to win a contest. There is no contest for me. Yes, I already know there's absolutely no contest for me at all. I'm contest free, completely contest free. I can never be in any contest. Yes, I already know I can never enter into any contest. Yes, I already know that I can never enter into any contest. So we have to forgive ourselves when we come into this world and we struggle and we're not professing like this enlightenment, because the world, you never hear this here, almost never. And they tell you, well, look at this as a contest. Look at this, and they try to get you, into this. But we have to counter this. Rarely is this countered here. So you face just this buzzsaw coming into the world here. So yes, I already know that I can never enter any contest. Yes, I already know that I can never enter into any contest. I already know that there is no prize for me. I'll never receive any prize. I already know that I can never receive any prize. Yes, I already know that I can never receive anything of value, that I'm completely valueless. Yes, I already know that I am completely valueless. All praise to the spirit of truth. Call it what you want. It's manifested. It's had various appearances here, which are nothing, of course. Yes, I already know I can never appear. Yes, I already know I can never appear. Yes, I already know I can never have any value. Yes, I already know I'm absolutely free of any value. Yes, I already know I'm absolutely free of any appearance. I can never appear anywhere. I can never appear as anything. I can never appear anywhere. I can never appear. I can never appear. And just practice this and see what your reaction is. The only way we're going to recognize, the only way is to actually practice instead of saying, now wait a minute, and thinking about it. That's not going to help at all. Actually assert these and then see how your reaction is. You see, this is what we're doing here. Making the assertions with faith behind it and say, yes, I know I can never appear anywhere. I know I'm incapable of ever appearing. I know that appearance doesn't exist for me. I know that appearance is impossible. I know that appearance is impossible. I already know that appearance is absolutely impossible for me. Appearances appear, but I am not an appearance. So I already know that appearance is absolutely impossible for me. So when you're practicing, there's no second thoughts happening. We're simply practicing asserting this, and then seeing how we feel, what the reaction is. I call this phase four practice. It's the highest practice. Before, you might be thinking about this, like thinking, now can I appear? I wonder if I can appear. Is appearance possible? You know, is it, maybe it's possible, maybe it's nothing. That doesn't get you anywhere. That's spinning the wheels. It's you might say that's flipping the script. Okay, if you look at it that way. But flipping the script is actually getting us ready for what? Assertions. Its purpose is to lead us back into assertion, where we drop flipping the script. When we're in this assertion mode, we're not flipping the script. We're not thinking about it. We're asserting it. Yes, I already know that opportunity is impossible for me. Cut and dried. Just say it. And own it completely. Own it completely. Just embrace it and own it. Yes, I already know that opportunity is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that I have absolutely no value whatsoever. Yes, I already know that I have absolutely no definition whatsoever. I am spirit. I am free. I am still, well, I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Or I am spirit, I am free. I am still exactly as God created me. I am spirit, I am free. I am still exactly as God created me. I am spirit, I am free. I am still exactly as God created me. I am spirit. I am free. I am still exactly as God created me. That's another way to say it. I would say, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am spirit. I am free. I am still exactly as God created me. I am spirit. I am free. I am still exactly as God created me. I am absolutely nothing. I am absolutely nowhere. I am absolutely never. I never am. See, just I am spirit. I am free, but I never am. I never am. It's just I am. I can never be found. Yes, I already know that I can never be found. Yes, I already know I can never be reached. Yes, I already know I can never be touched. Yes, I already know I can never be realized. Yes, I already know I can never be attained. Once you see the severity of how we deceive ourselves, then you will certainly get on board with this kind of practice. Just say it's either this or the other. And the other is, don't even want to think about it actually. Want to keep practicing. It's the kind of thing you want to, you see it and you say, okay, I don't want to look at it anymore. It's that terrible. So, yes, I already know that I'm already absolutely nothing. Yes, I already know that I'm already absolutely nothing. And of course, this relates to the fact that we're formless, we're spirit, we're absolutely nothing. And we're absolutely never. Freedom, pure freedom. How can you put freedom, pure freedom, say it's in time or anywhere? I'm absolutely nowhere. I'm absolutely nowhere. Yes, I already know that I'm absolutely nowhere. I don't know if I mentioned it in a previous video, but as I was sitting here, maybe after I stopped taping, two California quail walked right along the path here, about, you know, 6-7 feet away from me. Maybe, yeah. Let's say within 10 feet. And they were just, you know how quail walk, like that. Of course, if you don't live in California, you probably don't have California quail, but you know, maybe there's quail, imagine, other places too. So, and they're just walking right along the path here looking for stuff. Now you say, well, okay, what's the big deal? The big deal is we have not seen quail here for maybe 40 years. I cannot remember the last time we saw quail here. We used to have quail, and they disappeared. They disappeared. And then suddenly, I'm sitting here, 40 years later, maybe, you know, 40 years later or more, and there's quails just walking right past me right here. I mean, what? And you think, wait a minute, I haven't seen any quail here since I was a boy, you know? This is extraordinary. So maybe that symbol, something's coming back to me that I lost when I was younger. You know, lost this, the truth of what of I am. Not of what I am, the truth of I am. I am nothing. I am nowhere. I am never. I am absolutely never. See, the more we say this with intensity and conviction, the more the wow reaction arises. Yes, I already know. I have absolutely no accomplishment. Accomplishment is totally impossible for me. See, this, there you go. That's just countering the world, what the world tells us, right? So yes, I already know that accomplishment is absolutely impossible for me. It's impossible for me to experience accomplishment. It's impossible for me to experience progress. It's impossible for me to experience attainment. It's impossible for me to experience realization. It's impossible for me to experience value. It's impossible for me to experience definition. Let me dial back this a little bit. If I can. Full stop in the wow. Don't struggle with your reaction. Don't try to define it. Don't try to define it. I already know that definition is impossible for me. You see, this world is telling you all these things are possible for you. They're actually impossible for you. It's impossible for me to be in any contest. I can never enter into any contest. Why? There isn't any contest in reality. Contest is impossible in reality. What I am can never be contested. Body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am spirit, I am free, I am still exactly as God created me. And there, this is having, continue to have this cool feeling. And affecting me. So there is a. So we acknowledge this has been a strain. This is like the ultimate strain. This is the ultimate video so far in terms of practice. I was able to focus in better on what needs to be practiced because of the experience that I had, the awareness and seeing that I had. It says, oh, wow. Okay. I asked this Holy Spirit, how do I practice now? How do I practice now? And so this is the Holy Spirit's answer. This is what we're called to practice. We're called to practice in this way. We are called to practice in this way. Yes, I already know that I am absolutely nothing. Yes, I already know that I am absolutely nowhere. Yes, I already know that I am absolutely never. So you say, I never am. I never am. Truth is, it's just simply, I am. Okay. But we can say, very important, say, I never am. I never am. I already know that I absolutely never am. I am absolutely nothing. I am never anything whatsoever. Yes, I already know that I'm absolutely never anything whatsoever. Yes, I already know I'm absolutely never anywhere whatsoever. So I'm absolutely nowhere. Could keep going. I don't know if I will or not. I just just check in with the wow. And what do I have? I have a feeling of elation, because just getting to this, I realize this is tremendous. This is really tremendous. There's a sort of a sense of freedom. I feel close to freedom. Close to I am. I am what? Freedom. I am freedom. That's it. And there's also, you know, the trepidation of like, whoa, you can't say this. How can you be saying these things? What's going to happen to you saying these things? You're never going to succeed. You're never going to accomplish. Whoa, you know, woe is you, stuff like that. And continuity fear, you know, so this is all kind of, it's all present. But what we do is we maintain our basic discipline. Okay, the basics are so important, because you always have to fall back on them at some point. Just like if you're a piano player, the basics are so important, because if you're attempting something very difficult and you get through it, where do you go? I mean, what do you do? You have to end it at some point. What do? You, there's always the basics that you can fall back on that sound great and smooth, and you know, you can always fall back on that. See, the wheels never come off. Wheels never come off. When you're thoroughly schooled in being able to do the basics, fundamentally sound and beautifully, that's always there. That's always there. So we can always sit quietly. See, we can always succeed at that. We can always succeed at sitting quietly. That's why I always insist on the basics. That's how I was taught piano. The basics, always insist on the basics. Perfect the basics so they're always there. Always rock solid. Never lost. And always stay in touch with the basics. Hey, I'm sitting here. I'm sitting still. Sitting quietly. Full stop in the wow. See, all those are the basics. And so this enables us to use these tremendous assertions. And then when we stop, you know, a little tired and full stop on the wow, we say, oh, there's no break in continuity. I'm sitting here quietly. I'm sitting here, you know, hands to hands, not acting out, not eating, not singing, not, you know, reacting. Full stop on the wow. I'm just here sitting quietly. Smooth. Everything's smooth. There's no question that I've transferred all the abilities that I had in a previous life in various ways. In one, for instance, all the piano practicing I did, which was a lifelong practice I did, into spiritual practicing. Now, when you do some play that is just superiorly, beautifully, just some extraordinary play, what do? You say, wow, what did I just hear? Oh my gosh. But the basics are still there, and you keep on playing and throwing this lovely variations on just some basic easy stuff. You know, it still sounds beautiful. And you just keep that one, keep smooth it out until you kind of, you know, you calm down. It's the same thing in spiritual practice. Same thing in spiritual practice. As we've done these tremendous assertions, some of the best assertions that have ever been done here on this planet, actually, to say what we've been saying. It's extraordinary, extraordinary great medicine for us. And yet we're still playing. We're just full stop in the wow here. Staying still, calm, poised. Not restless. Not frozen, but not restless, okay? There's a middle path. Not frozen and not restless. Stick just sort of at peace, still, calm. Not agitated. We're not trying to freeze ourselves up because that's an unnatural effort. We just sit here stable, not going to spring into any sort of action whatsoever. So there's different, this is real practice, just like piano. Some piano practice is real practice, others isn't. I also, in teaching others, I found that most people came there, they wanted to impress their significant other, or they wanted to impress someone. In terms of, you know, an ego thing, like arrogance, look how successful I can be. You know, look, I can play this real, you know, flowery sort of passage, and someone will say, "Oh my gosh, you're that's just wonderful. You're such a winner. You're so clever. That's amazing." You know, and you say, "Yeah," until you get this ego kick on it. Whereas, like for me, it was different. Practicing was like a lifelong situation to elevate the culture and to try and get others to practice also. I say, "Hey, if this is something that you want to do, get into this habit of practicing." It was sort of trying to elevate discipline and practice and determination and to cultivate these high spiritual qualities that we need to ultimately be liberated from this delusion. And at that time, playing piano was all the rage, of course, in Europe. Anyone, all the bourgeoisie, took piano lessons and played piano. Even some of the aristocrats did. They mostly, though, hired you to play for them. So same with spiritual practice is, you know, you're a lifer. This is discipline that you recognize is supremely important. And so we sweat the basics. You see, when people came to me for lessons, they didn't want to spend time on the basics. I said, "Well, you need to spend about 5 years or so practicing the basics and thoroughly understanding the whole structure of the basic structure, so that is ingrained in you and is never something you have to think about or reach for, because when you're reaching for something, you want to be able to fall back on something you don't have to reach for. And so you can't really reach high unless you're very confident that if you've got a net beneath you. You know, when you're walking on a tightrope, which is what a lot of those, you know, fancy playing is, walking like on a tightrope. And that's why people are listening, say, "Oh my gosh, are they going to mess up? Are they going to mess up?" Just like when we watch a tightrope walker. Well, if you've got a net beneath you, you're not worried, you know, it gives you this confidence. never let them see you sweat. You see, so you're not trying to impress some significant other, some special relationship or something. But that's most that's what they wanted. That's what they wanted, and their lives were busy with all sorts of other stuff. They just wanted to show that they're Renaissance people, and oh, sure, I can dash off something very dashing on the piano. Any time at all, I can, as I'm whipping up some, you know, delectable meal, and then after the meal, oh yeah, so I'll go to the piano and I'll, you know, do some dashing playing, and then you know, we're going to go out on the town dancing, and you know, I'm a dashing Renaissance person that can do it all, that sort of thing. That doesn't fly when it comes to the spiritual practice. That doesn't fly. See, they can never get to this type of assertion and have it smooth. If you're merely trying to be socially impressive, trying to up your status, show what a bon vivant you are, what a all-faceted talented person you are, and say the people say, wow, where'd you learn to do that? Ah, you know, I fit a few lessons in, you know, and don't have much time, but I fit a few lessons in. So they think by going to some real famous accomplished virtuoso that somehow the virtuoso should be able to like teach them in a few lessons how to be really great. You know, this is the extreme delusion on their part. As if there's some secret that they've discovered and that if you pay them money, that they will share the secret with you. And they say, well, hey, I'll pay you, look, hundreds of dollars. I'll pay you a lot. Just show me how to play that way. You know, it's just some secret. They don't understand that you've dedicated your life to it. They think that's stupid. They think they're superior to you. I'm doing everything good. You know, I'm doing everything good. Didn't Jesus say, go take all your jewelry, and when you find this pearl of great price, sell it all for that one pearl of great price? Well, the pearl of great price is this dedication to become an absolute virtuoso. And that's what we're doing here. This is being a virtuoso in meditation, in contemplation, in assertion, in spiritual practice, really. Be a virtuoso in spiritual practice. Don't try to be a Renaissance person. This is what I found. I ran into this buzzsaw again here. Is somehow you're trying to, and it's always to impress some special people that you think that their adulation of you is necessary. And somehow it's this idea of I can do it all. We're caught up in this nonsense of I can do it all. So spiritual practice, that people think, oh, I just need to find a guru, they'll give me a mantra, and I can just say that a few times a week, and I'll be like blissful, and then I can impress everybody with, oh yeah, why you're so blissful? Oh yeah, I fit in a little bit of meditation along with, you know, all the music and the travel and the work and the parties and, you know, the kids and everything. Yeah, you know, I went to a guru and occasionally I do a little spiritual practice, and that's why I'm so blissful. You know, like they feel it's like this. It's like a recipe, you know. Like you go to the teacher and say, oh yeah, the secret recipe. And they say, well, they'll pay you for it. Don't worry. Secret, like secret sauce or like Coca-Cola recipe or some secret recipe. If you just, they just get the recipe, then, you know, just, oh, okay, that's easy. I just, now that I know what the recipe is. Remember, the spiritual practice is patience. Renaissance people have no patience. And someone once told me that was their main vice, that they don't have enough patience. They admitted it. They said, I just don't have enough patience. Can't do it. So they're, you know, busy trying to be a Renaissance person. Oh yeah, well, today I was in the Zen garden, and or yesterday, you know, and or yesterday I was in the Zen garden. Wow, today I'm on the beach in Goa, and I'm going up to Delhi. You know, there's a guru. I'm going to go see a guru. There's a conference up there, and there's a guru I know. I'm going to drop in there, see the guru, and then I'm back to England. There's a meditation retreat in England. I'm going to attend that for a couple of days, and then there's a symposium in New York. You know, some people talking about this, and in between that, I'm doing this art, and writing a book, and I'm actually looking to take a few music lessons. I think I could also master music pretty easily, and this is I'm very successful. I'm a well-rounded Renaissance. This is winning. See, this is winning. Sort of strategy doesn't result in doesn't enable I am to accept I am. It's always I am something, I am somewhere, I am somebody, I am winning. Yes, I already know that winning is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that I'm absolutely nobody. Yes, I already know that I'm absolutely nothing, no thing. Yes, I already know I'm absolutely nowhere, no place. Yes, I already know I have absolutely no talents. Yes, I already know I have absolutely no capabilities. Yes, I already know I have no accomplishments. Yes, I already know I have success is impossible for me. Yes, I already know I have no secrets. There are no secrets. Yes, I already know that secrets don't exist for me. Yes, I already know that secrets are impossible for me. Secret knowledge is impossible for me. Most spiritual seekers are of this variety. They're seeking, they're trying to win. I think that this is a winning strategy. So I'm going to find somebody who's already won, who's going to teach me how to win. Yes, I already know that winning is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that success is impossible for me. Yes, I already know that there's nothing I can ever attain. Yes, I already know there is no prize for me. I can never receive any prize. Yes, I already know I can never get anything. Yes, I already know that it's impossible for me to ever get anything. Yes, I already know I can never get it. Eventually, I stopped teaching piano. I said, it's useless. It's useless. A waste of time. Yes, I already know I can never be a teacher. Right? It's impossible. There's nothing to teach. There's absolutely nothing we can ever be taught. There's absolutely nothing we can ever learn. Yes, I already know there's absolutely nothing I can ever learn. Yes, I already know there's absolutely nothing that I can ever teach. Absolutely nothing to teach. Yes, I already know no one has anything to teach. I cannot be taught. I cannot be taught. Absolutely. Yes, I already know that I can never be taught anything. Yes, I already know that I can never be taught anything. What is perfectly all in all can hardly be said to be taught anything. No, yes, I already know that I can never be taught anything. And yes, I already know that I can never learn anything whatsoever. I'm perfectly free of learning, perfectly free of teaching. There is no teacher, there is no student, there is no teaching. No teaching, no teacher, no student. No teaching, no teacher, no student. Yes, I already know there's no teaching, there's no teacher, and there's no student. Well, I feel like the wow is so strong that I'm starting to feel some struggle. When you feel that something, you feel stuck, something's perplexing you, and boss starting to bother you, the wow has gotten very strong, and you need to just focus on that and make sure you don't struggle. Stay neutral. No yes, no no. Neither yes or no. I don't know anything. Yes, I already know. There's absolutely nothing that I can ever do. I can never do anything. Yes, I already know that I can never do anything. And we can also say, yes, I already know I can never know anything. I can never know anything. I can never know anywhere. I can never know anyone. I can never do anything. Yes, I already know that I can never do anything whatsoever. Now, the funny thing is that we're taught here, from cradle to grave, that all these positive assertions that we're saying, that awaken us from this, that help us disidentify and not struggle with this illusion, self-delusion we're imagining. We're taught that all of that is like a negative self-image. We believe a positive self-image has to do with accomplishments, right? Attainments and all this learning, teaching, learning, doing. knowing, succeeding. And so the truth is then flipped, and it seems like it's a negative. And we have to stay away from it. We look at that as the darkness, as the evil, as the darkness. And we're trying to defeat that darkness. So we symbolize it as darkness, actually. And, wow. But now we're bringing it up and saying, no, this is actually the light. This is actually the light. And it's the fake light of accomplishment and success and teaching, learning, doing, all this. That's the darkness, really. That's the darkness. That's the delusion. And so, we have concluded a great session here in the mood of repentance. We don't throw level confusion into it. Instead, we full stop in the wow of it. Glass is half full for us. See, half empty, we mean level confusion. We start struggling and say, wait a minute, you said this, and this contradicts with that and that. The half empty, no, half full. Full stop in the wow. Neither yes nor no. Just a neutral. Neutral, neutral. Don't struggle. Don't try to force anything. Don't try to apply it. Assertions are already self-applied as we say them. They're being applied. Our faith applies them. Our doing it applies it. Okay. It evaporates the continuity fear. It evaporates it. So, the evaporation is taking place now. Just let it happen. Just let the evaporation happen. Okay. Very great. I am going to get... I need to do some work. I actually have a little bit of work today. So, very great. This has been tremendous. 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 And now... remain in full stop in the wow. If you feel stuck, if you feel flat, depressed, realize it's the wow. Just go back to the wow. And say, hey, I'm still in the wow reaction here. And then have confidence that you will get back to your practicing at some point too. Right? Okay. Very great. That's it for this one.